Hi everyone, I am Dr. James with information I believe is important at this time. Vitamin D is instrumental in the immune system's ability to fight against viruses and bacteria. The immune system needs it so much that certain immune cells were created with their own enzyme to make activated vitamin D and with receptors for activated vitamin D. Vitamin D also helps the immune system stay balanced or regulated so it does not destroy the body. Research has demonstrated that vitamin D deficiency correlated with higher rates of influenza and HIV infections, respiratory illnesses, and autoimmune disorders like lupus and rheumatoid arthritis. Well, vitamin D deficiency is generally found in greater proportions among persons living in temperate regions and among older people. Interestingly, we are seeing more cases and deaths from COVID-19 among these two populations. In addition, people who are ill and hospitalized wherever they are in the world can become vitamin deficient while fighting illnesses and due to decreased diet and lack of sunshine. Please consult your physician before following this advice, but we know the starter material for vitamin D first becomes D3 in the skin by direct sunlight. 30 minutes of sunshine is generally enough time. It then eventually becomes activated vitamin D by an enzyme in the kidneys or certain immune cells. We can also get D3 from foods and through supplements. To maintain adequate vitamin D levels, the recommended daily allowance is 600 international units per day, whereas the Endocrine Society suggests 1500 international units per day. Too much of anything is bad. Consistently taking smaller daily doses has proven better than taking big weekly or monthly doses. Patients need to have vitamin D levels checked to detect deficiency, as it may make them more susceptible to the effects of COVID-19. In short, vitamin D seems very important in the fight against COVID-19. In fact, all vitamins, especially those which benefit the immune system, such as vitamin D and C, cannot be overlooked now. Humanity has not seen this virus before. We need all the fighting power we can get. Let us ensure we keep our vitamin and mineral levels within normal range and get this information out to as many people as possible. Below are the articles I've used to prepare this talk and a presentation.